And a commander has a scarf on because it's going to get chilly with today's game, Frostbite, for your Atari 2600. Let's go ahead and take Frostbite. Let's pop it in my Atari 7800 Pro system and see how it holds up today. Let's go to the game. Frostbite was published by Activision and carries a cover year 1983, meaning it most likely came out near the great video game crash in the United States. It was programmed by Steve Cartwright, who also programmed Sequest for the 2600, which I reviewed in episode 232. I'll put a link to that review in the description below. The manual opens with the following. The object of the game is to help Frostbite Bailey build igloos by jumping on floating blocks of ice. Be careful to avoid these deadly hazards. Killer clams, snow geese, Alaskan king crab, grizzly polar bears, and the rapidly dropping temperature. Frostbite is a single screen action game with some Froggert and Qbert style elements for one or two players alternating, with two levels of difficulty. The harder difficulty starts you on the fifth level. For the controls, you use your joystick to move Frostbite Bailey, including jumping on the ice floes. Every time you jump on an ice floe while it's white, you will turn the ice floe blue and add a block to your igloo. When you turn all four ice floes blue, they will revert back to white, allowing you to jump on them again to continue building your igloo. While on the ice floes, you need to avoid crabs, geese, and clams, but you could collect fish for points. You can reverse an ice floe you are standing on by pressing the button, but it will cost you an ice block from your igloo unless it's already fully built. If you get far enough, a polar bear will show up that you will also need to avoid. Once your igloo is fully built, you can enter it to go to the next level. As you are playing, the temperature drops. If it drops to zero, you lose a life. You also lose a life by getting pushed off screen or jumping into the icy sea. Scoring wise, you get 10 points per ice block on level 1 and 160 points for entering the igloo, and those values increase as you move up the levels. You also get 200 points per fish and bonus points when you enter the igloo based on the temperature. The warmer it gets, the more points you get. At every 10,000 points, you earn an extra life. When the game originally came out, you could also send a picture of your score of 40,000 points or more to get an Arctic Architects patch. Graphically speaking, I found this to be an above average looking game, and I liked how the time of day changed from level to level. The game also sports some solid Activision sound effects. Family friendly wise, the game would most likely get an E for Everyone rating if released today. Currently at PriceTrying.com, the game has a value of $13 loose, $37 complete, and $61 new. So what did I think of Frostbite for the 2600? Honestly, I wasn't impressed at first, but the more I played it, the more I warmed up to it. It controls well, and using the button to reverse ice floes is an interesting mechanic. It's also one of those 2600 games that are rather simple and easy to get into, but are executed well and worth a spot in most retro gamers' rotations. So where am I going to rank Frostbite? I'm looking somewhere in my top 75. I do like Star Raiders more at 68, but I'm willing to put it over the also fun Cosmic Arc at 69. So out of the 221 games that are now ranked for the Atari 2600, Frostbite is trying to avoid snow geese at the 69 ranking. Frostbite offers some icy cold fun for the 2600, but that's just my opinion. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Also, please like, share, and subscribe. Follow me both on the Facebook and the Twitter. Click the bell so you don't miss any future videos. And sign up at patreon.com/noswordgamer, just like Jose Q did, to support the show and gain access to exclusive perks. Thank you for giving me a little part of your day, and I look forward to seeing you next time on the next episode of the Noswore Gamer. Take care and watch out for killer clams from outer space, who are now in the Arctic Ocean for reasons.